Hey, today I'm working in DaVinci Resolve 16 and I'm going to go over all the details of using retime controls in Resolve, and it's super cool. It does a lot of things for you, including changing the speed of the clips. It can do reverse, freeze frame, a whole lot of things, and I'm going to dig into the details of how to use it so you can be an expert at this really quick, so stay tuned. Okay, so I have a clip here, just an action shot of a surfer. I'll go ahead and delete out the audio. I'm not going to need that. So scrubbing through my clip here, and we can just see we have a shot that's focusing on this surfer here on top of the wave. It's just a short clip. And I want to take this and I'm going to add some different effects to it. Okay, to add these effects, I'm going to use the retime controls, and there's two ways to apply retime to your clip. You can right click on the clip and you can say retime controls, or you can just hit Control R and we add the retime controls immediately, and we can get into doing a speed ramp, or we can do a lot of other things here. So I'll go ahead and show you the different options. Once you have that speed ramp in place, go ahead and just click on this little arrow here and we're going to get some different options. We can add speed point, change speeds. It gives us a range of options there. We can reset it to 100, which is the default. We can go to freeze frame. We can reverse the segment. We can do a rewind segment where it's going to play the video and rewind. We can do a speed ramp. We can go up from 0% down to 0%, and we can reset it back to the original state, and it will do pitch correction on your audio. If you have this selected, you can turn that off or on, and I don't have any audio, so it doesn't really matter for me right now. So I'm going to go ahead and add some different points in here. Go ahead and change the speed. We'll go down to a 50%, and that's automatically going to make the length of my video clip much longer. I'll go ahead and undo that so you can see. Let's go ahead and change that again to 50, and that's going to double the length of my overall clip but make the speed half as much. And so now we're in a slow motion. I'm going to go ahead and pull this down. I'm going to say add speed point. Let's go ahead and add a few speed points in there. Okay. So I'm going to change this speed up to a 75. Add another speed point. Change this one. Go ahead and do 150. And I'm going to go ahead and add another speed point in there. And so what we're going to see now is you're going to see some different arrow colors. So if you see blue arrows and they're tightly spaced, that means you are going at a speed that is faster than the original clip. If you're seeing yellow arrows, then they're a little bit further apart and it's showing you that you are going slower than the original clip. And let me go ahead and make a different selection on here. I'm going to say rewind at 100%. And so now the arrow direction changes backwards. And so that's telling us that it is going in reverse. And I can go really fast and do some different things there. I'll go ahead and undo that. You're gonna see these little points in there, and I was adding some in there earlier and they're kind of layering on top of each other. So there's some extra ones in here. So if we grab this pull handle on the bottom, it is just going to change the amount of video that is being affected by that percent video. So if we have this 50% video speed and I move that, it's going to select less there. Okay, and if I grab this top bar here, you can see now that is going to change the speed of my video. So if I pull it in closer, it is going to get faster. And if I pull it out here, it's going to get much slower. So that's an easy way to manipulate any type of video that you want. Say you want to get to a certain point and fill in a certain amount of video in your project, you can just grab these and you can make it right on the point that you want. And so that's pretty easy to do. Okay, so those are some really great options for us. Go ahead and get in here a little bit closer. And so we talked about the reverse speed and we talked about the forward speed. We can also go in here and we can add a freeze frame. And so this is going to add a piece of segment that just stops the video and freezes it for however long you want. You can change this one, make it longer or shorter. And when you do that freeze frame, it is going to set up these red hash marks, which are means that the video is not progressing. It is staying in that spot. And so that is very nice. And if I want to get rid of all this, or if I want to change this back to 100, I can say reset back to 100. And if I want to clear the whole thing, I can just say reset the clip and we're back to the original state. I can do a speed ramp, which is, let's do an up from zero. And so it's going to progressively take us from 10% up to 30, 50, 70, 90. It's going to take us in those increments. Like I said, if you want to add some more points in here, you can add these points and you can clear points as well, however you want to do it, which is really handy. And you can still do all the same things that you can do with a normal clip. You can drag that out, just do a portion of it. We can trim these. We can do whatever we want with these. So these are very flexible and very, very easy to use. You always want to close this when you're done. It just makes things a lot more in control. So if I want to go in and reverse the entire clip, I can just click on it, hit Control R again. This is going to open up all my controls. I can just reset this whole thing to 100. And I can go in here and just say reverse segment. And so my arrows change now, and I'm going to start from the end and work my way back to the start. And so one more thing to mention, let's go ahead and open up the retime controls again, Control R, and I'm going to go ahead and get rid of this point here to the start. So this time I'm going to go in and I'm going to change the speed to 10%. And so let's take a look at that. It's really jerky. And we're still going in reverse here. So remember, if we look at our settings, so make sure the clip is still selected, go to the inspector up here, click on the retime and scaling controls here. These are going to usually default to project settings for retime processing and motion estimation. These are the algorithms that are being used to set up your slow motion. I've gone all the way from 100% down to 10%. And so this is just a very low setting. This is the nearest setting by default. If we go to a frame blend, it's going to get much better. You can see the smoothness there, but we still have all these artifacts going on because it's trying to do these in-between shots in between the frames that it had originally shot. And so there's another option that's a lot better. It's called the optical flow. And the first one is a faster estimation. And you can see already how much better that got. And that's on the lowest one. That's a really fast setting for the algorithm. We can go up to the enhance faster. And it even gets better. There is an optical flow speed warp. And that is great. But let me show you just real quick. It really uses a lot of processor. And so if you got a beefy machine, that's great. But it's going to take a little while. I'm going to go ahead and stop that. Get back. Even this enhanced better runs fine, and this machine is just really a medium quality. It's a little jumpy, but when you render that out, it's going to be really smooth. And so take a look at those as well. I do have a separate video on these different settings, and I compare the different video options and I render through some different things. So take a look for that on my channel, and you can kind of see the comparison between the different settings. So if you have a really long video that you're trying to do slow motion on, these are going to become really important. If it's a really short clip and you don't mind waiting around for 15, 20 minutes, which, for a 8 second or so video, depending on your machine, that speed warp is probably going to take you 15 or 20 minutes to render that out. If you have something really fast, a great processor, an i9 or something, it will be a lot faster. But for most of us, this is my second machine. I do not hook up my studio machine to the internet, so I make everything on this for you guys, and it really just gives you a demonstration of a very mediocre machine. It's got 16 gigs of RAM, it's got an i7, and it's got a 960 GTX mobile, so it's nothing fancy, but it does the job. So you probably have something a little bit better than that, so please play around with these settings, and these work really well. Okay, one more thing I want to show you guys. Let's go ahead and go in here, and I'm going to reset this clip again. And I will add an actual speed ramp this time, up from zero. I'm going to zoom out a little bit so we can see this whole clip here. And so make sure in your settings up here in Retime and Scaling, you have it set on something. It's not set on project settings. And for this one, I'm going to have it on optical flow, just an enhanced faster flow here. And so remember, we had those little pieces here because, and I'll open that up again. We have the speed ramp on. I'm hitting Control R to turn this off and on. So we see all these little points in here. Let me close that again and go ahead and hit this curve down here. Let me get this out of the way a little bit here so we have a little bit more real estate to work with. Okay, so when we do the pull down here, there are a couple of options here at the bottom when we're using retime controls. And I had somebody in I did a DaVinci Resolve 15 version using the retime controls, using the speed ramp. And one of the folks on there mentioned that in After Effects and Adobe Premiere, it was so easy to use it. And he wished this was possible in DaVinci Resolve 15, 16. It is possible, and you just gotta know where to look. So open up this curve, and this one is the retime speed, and this one is the retime frame. If we open both of these, we're going to get the curve points. And so let me go ahead and close this frame down. You can see these breakpoints where it's going from 10%, 30%, 50, 70, 90. And so if we click on these curve points here, let's go ahead and click that. And it's going to let us select these actual points here. And if you want to drag these, you can move them, obviously. But if you pull these curves out here, see, it makes them really sharp changes, or you can go very gradual. So if you just use this setting here, the curve setting, and pull these bars out as far as you can, it's basically going to be almost a linear change. So there we go. And so now if we go through this, we're not going to see those jumps quite nearly as much when it changes the speed. It's having a little bit of a hard time keeping up, so I'm going to jump it to the faster mode. And now when we're jumping up from 70 to 90, it's just a very subtle change, and that gives it a little bit different look than you're probably used to. It's almost like a linear progression from zero all the way up to full speed here. So you can set it however you want, obviously using these curve points. Hopefully that gives you a pretty good idea of using retime controls in DaVinci Resolve 16 and some of the great new features such as that awesome slow motion estimation using the speed warp if you have the processing power. So take a look at that. Use that in your projects. It's really fantastic and it's so easy to use. So thanks for watching again. Please subscribe to the channel if you liked this video and you want to see more just like it. And thanks again for watching. Take care.